I've been dreaming on in my head like I've seen it. A life worth living is a life with meaning. I'll do what I love till my heart stops beating. I'm feeding this demon. Got a taste, can't erase bitterness in my face. Work a job every day till your dreams fade away. Like a card, never change, play the game that we say. I need a break.
Good afternoon, guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me today. A reminder, make sure you're subscribed. Make sure YouTube has not unsubscribed you. And please thumbs up my videos. There was an earthquake along the Grand Banks near Newfoundland, a magnitude 4.5 according to USGS, but actually it was like a 5.0. Over on the left here, we got Maine. Up over here, we got Newfoundland. And it struck me where this earthquake occurred because in 1929, there was a failure of the Grand Banks after a 7.2 earthquake that created a huge tsunami that went all the way across the Atlantic. 28 people died. Lots of infrastructure. Homes were washed into the ocean here, the Atlantic Ocean. 17 undersea cables were destroyed, ripped up. The shipping ports destroyed, etc. It was really bad in 1929. That earthquake created a collapse of the bank itself, the total bank. And it fell about 300 feet, which created the tsunami. Like I said, this earthquake probably was a magnitude 5.0. Actually, 5.04. And it probably created a landslide. No tsunami, thank God. But the reason I say there was landslides, because you will notice here, let me go down, go over, see all this disturbance, gases. It's probably mud and other debris that was brought up. Now, this is a half an hour later. It was still going on. And then about an hour later, yeah, it was still going on. An hour and a half later, we still got indication. See that? The lines going up and plus all the disturbance. And then, yeah, going down farther. And this is what it was when I just got done pulling the files. But yeah, it wasn't a 4.5. It was actually probably a 5.0. And I got two monitors that I downloaded it from. One, I believe, is from St. John, and the other one from Prince Edward Island. So the monitor is about 153 miles. USGS has south, but it's actually north. Yeah, boy, did they mess up. Here's the earthquake, and here's St. Pierre. Yeah. Boy, if they can't get the location right, yeah, what else are they going to mess up on? Now, as you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. And yeah, we know that the plates are moving. Recently, there was some earthquakes down here. Oh, this one here was April 14th. Let's see, and this is Prince Edward Island. This one here was January. Oh, that was last year. Excuse me. This one here was May 24th of this year. I can't remember ever seeing an earthquake out here along the Grand Banks. Yeah, in my memory of since I've been covering earthquakes. Yeah, so it should be a wake-up call for all of you. Seeing how that does have a past history, there's no moment tensor ball. It looks like there was some landslides created, underwater landslides from the Grand Bank collapsing. No moment tensor ball or anything like that about fault zones running through here. Yeah, I was very much surprised. So, what are your thoughts? Yeah, put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.